Is this an old school workout? Have you done this one before?
I probably have done it somewhere along the lines, but it's nice. It's kind of like, you know, classic movements, deadlift thruster. It's, I have a feeling it's, you know, it's one of those ones that sounds like, yeah, okay, cool. You know, 2159 deadlifts and thrusters, all right. And then you get into it and it really kind of sucks. It probably is going to have a little bit of a Fran punch. I mean, range of motion is the same, and then I'd imagine the time domain is just about the same.
Yeah.
It's just pulling from the ground instead of pulling to overhead, you know. Hey, I'm developing a new relationship with the camera.
Oh, yeah.
Like, I love the camera. I love being on camera.
In order to pick the bar up from the ground, first thing she's going to do is send the butt back and maintain this nice neutral position here. And if you were to look at it from the side, what I typically like to see is for the knees, the hips, and the shoulders to be on three different levels. This should look almost like a push play button on the side of a CD player. From here, she's going to extend the legs while making sure this angle stays the same till she clears the knees, and then from there she opens the hip all the way back up. In order to take the bar back down to the ground, she's going to pull the hips back, which is going to send the torso forward, clear the knees, and then settle that angle back down. The main point here is I would love to have this angle stay the same throughout the entire range of motion and relax, okay? Now, all of this stuff is fine and dandy. It's really cool to have great camaraderie and stuff during the workout, but how many times do you ever get to say that you get to work out with one of the original Nasty Girls? So Nicole Carroll, the director of training, is here, and honestly, I don't even care what position I come in, whether first or last. It's just going to be cool to have something documented that I got a chance to work out with her, which is pretty freaking cool, man. There's a couple of ways that this could happen. We could allow her to clean the load up to the shoulders and then go into her squat, or she could go right into a squat clean on the first repetition. Points of performance are very similar to a front squat, but just a little bit different because there is a little bit of a press involved. Not a little bit, there's a lot of a press involved here. But the bottom line is, at the very bottom, I want the butt to go back, weight down in the heels, go down to the bottom and hold for me. Good, in this position, it should look just like a front squat with the exception of the elbows maybe slightly down because she has a full grip on the bar. Hip crease below the knee, weight in the heels, lumbar curve is there, knees are pressed out. Upon the rise, she's gonna explode with the hips, boom, and launch the barbell up overhead. A couple of things I'm looking for right away. I wanna make sure that the hip extends before she starts pressing into the bar. That's a classic quad extremity violation and re-rack it. Good. And the other thing that I want to make sure is that she is getting that full range of motion. Again, I want the barbell directly stacked over her shoulder, over her hips, and over her heels.
I felt like the first time you did Fran where thrusters were just impossible.
Yeah.
For some reason you're resting with the weight overhead and you don't know why.
Yeah.
You know, you're like, why in the hell am I doing this? And then you bring it down and that hurts more and bad.
Yeah.
Go for the same Fran pace, figure the 15 is gonna suck. And get through that as quick as you can. Keep reminding yourself. Just get to the nines, because once you're on nine, it hurts, but it's like, I can do nine.
Yeah.
You know, I can do nine and I can do them right now because I want to be done.
Yeah,
so,
totally.
Yeah, that was a good workout. I'm an old lady crossfitter.